Order! Order! You are an incorrigible delinquent at times. Behave yourself, man!
The Metropolitan Police has decided not to open a criminal investigation into the family firm of the Conservative Party chairman, Grant Shapps, including the selling of software. In a letter to Mr. Shapps, a senior officer said legal advice had concluded that the selling of the software may constitute an offence of fraud. But following a full assessment, Scotland Yard has now closed the matter. Our political correspondent Michael Crick reports.
Police say they've assessed allegations made about Grant Shapps' business affairs, but won't be investigating. Yet big questions remain tonight after the Met revealed, unusually, their lawyers advised there may have been fraud in the selling of software. This is the website where Shapps and his wife used to sell it. Although Grant Shapps resigned as a director of his firm, How To Corp Limited, 5 years ago, his wife Belinda remained a sole director running the business from the family home in Hatfield. Scotland Yard wrote to the Labour MP Steve McCabe last month. Our assessment of the allegations made against How To Corp Limited and Mr. Grant Shapps MP is now complete, they wrote. Legal advice was sought, they said, which concluded that the selling of the software may constitute an offence of fraud, amongst others. They added, however, upon the conclusion of the assessment process, the MPS, Metropolitan Police Service, have decided not to instigate a criminal investigation and have now closed this matter.
But it is quite extraordinary to have a letter from our chief superintendent who says, we've taken legal advice. We believe that there may have been offences committed, but we're not able to do anything about it. And I'm slightly surprised at that.
When I caught up with Grant Shapps this lunchtime, he claimed to have forgotten about it. Dropped the case against you. Have you seen this?
Oh, right, yeah. Vaguely, I've forgotten all about it.
You've forgotten all about it?
Well, this is all a very old thing, and I think that the MP who wasted the police time may have something to...
But they say the selling of the software may constitute an offence of fraud.
Well, if you read the letter, it says absolutely nothing here of any interest. I thought you were here today about the Afghanistan.
It is of interest if a cabinet minister might have been involved in an offence of fraud.
I think the letter makes it perfectly clear that there's absolutely nothing here. And
well, it doesn't make it clear, as the lawyers said, it may constitute an offence of fraud.
I think that the MP who wasted police time, and it seems like it's been a year or something, really has questions to answer as to why they were wasting the police time.
When the fuss first arose last year, the Shapp firm's website was quickly taken down, but not before many people, including Channel 4 News, managed to copy many hundreds of pages of content. And it meant that the police managed to obtain a substantial chunk of the website content. But it wasn't enough, they say, to overcome the evidential barriers that they faced. One problem, I understand, was identifying any victims of the firm's activity. Last year, it was revealed Grant Shapps used to run his business using the name Michael Green. But Channel 4 News couldn't find several of the names on Shapps' website who were endorsing his software products. For instance, Corinne Stockheath of Surrey, England said,
buying How To Write A Newsletter was the best use of my time ever.
But the only Stockheath we could find anywhere was a PG Woodhouse character. And Shapps himself seemed very reluctant at the Tory conference to help us.
What about Corinne Stockheath of Surrey? Doesn't appear to be any Stockheath anywhere in the world. There doesn't appear to be a Stockheath anywhere in the world. Is she genuine? Is Richard Wharton of Tech Triots New York's genuine? Is JLM Richards of the Wollaston Trust? There doesn't appear to be a Wollaston Trust. Is he here?
Michael, everybody is genuine.
Fictitious testimonials might be deemed to be deception to gain a pecuniary advantage. A year later, we still haven't found Corinne Stockheath, and nor, it seems, has he.
Does Corinne Stockheath still exist? I asked you this last year. You said she did then. But have you managed to find her yet?
Michael, I know this is kind of all of great interest to you, but the truth of the matter is that this is all from, the testimonials and all this from like 10, 15 years ago. I'm afraid
no,
I
it's
can't
not 10
really
of
help.
It's much more recent than that.
Scotland Yard say the matter's now closed. But the questions persist for a cabinet minister who only this week told the BBC to be more transparent.
Michael Crick.